Yo, what is going on, my YouTube people? This is Gavin Asti here again with you for another video. And today I have the second of the three brand new operator school videos for Operation White Noise. Last time I did Vigil, so if you haven't seen that yet and you want to check it out, I will leave a link down in the description. But today we're going to be covering Dokkaebi. Also, if you aren't into the series, how it works is I go over each and every operator in Rainbow Six Siege and grade them on a scale of 1 to 10 in three different categories, being weapons, gadget, and versatility. Then I give them a final overall grade and tell you why I think you should use them. So with that said, jumping right into Dokkaebi, she is a 2 armor, 2 speed operator who is part of the ROK military, and her gadget is the Logic Bomb. Now, this allows you to upload a virus that forces enemy devices to emit a loud buzz, thereby compromising their position. And not only that, but some added benefits to her ability is the fact that she can hack into the enemy team's cameras from a dead defender's phone. I will talk a little bit more about her gadget later on, but we're gonna get right into the first category of weapons. So for weapons, I have given Dokkaebi a 9 out of 10. Similar to Vigil, I feel like she almost has the perfect package, but not quite there yet. Her weapons are incredible along with the secondary options that you have, but I feel like both of her primary weapons are kind of the high risk, high reward, and the fact that she doesn't have a solid full auto primary, I took off that 1 point. Nonetheless, she still has some very powerful weapons, and the first one that we're gonna dive a little bit deeper into is the MK14 EBR. This is an iconic rifle that a lot of you guys have probably seen in other video games, and it is a semi-auto DMR. It has very high damage with pretty low recoil and a pretty good mag size. Looking at the actual in-game stats of this weapon, it does 60 damage, which is on the higher side. It can take 2 to 3 shots to take out an enemy. That is, of course, if it is body shots. The fire rate is semi-automatic. You can spam fire it. However, it does have a limit to it. It's not quite as fast as you can click. The mobility is 50, and then the mag cap is 20. If you count the bullet that you put in the chamber, she has 21 to shoot at the enemy. Now, one of the best things about this weapon, as I said, is its low recoil. That's what really sets this DMR apart from the others. I would probably say it's my favorite in the game, and definitely up there on one of the best. As for how I like to run this weapon, there are many different loadouts that you can use. Personally, I like using ACOG, muzzle brake, and then an angled grip. Because that recoil is extremely low as it is, putting an angled grip won't really hurt you at all, as long as you make sure you're using the muzzle brake barrel attachment. If you're going to use a DMR, that's the best one to go. I will say the gun is also very effective if you use something like a hollow or reflex sight, but personally, I just like running the ACOG. I think a lot of people are going to like this weapon, and overall, it's very solid. However, you can struggle a little bit in close range, but that doesn't really stop Dokkaebi too much since both of her secondaries are machine pistols. But shifting over and talking a little bit more about her second primary weapon, which is the BOSG 12.2 double barrel slug shotgun. I did cover it yesterday in the video about Vigil. It's a great overall weapon. It's fun for memeing, and it is a very rewarding gun to use, but also not the most competitive. Taking a look at the in-game stats, it does 125 damage. It is a double barrel, so you only get 2 shots. You can fire them relatively quickly, but then you're going to have to reload right away. Mobility is 50, and again, the mag cap is 2. Now, as for what attachments I like to use on the shotgun, would have to be holographic and vertical grip. Since you can fire those 2 shots off pretty quickly before the sights kind of reset, to kind of maintain some of that recoil, I like using the vertical grip. But also, I have found the angled grip does work if you fire a little bit slower. It's just better for snapping onto people in close range. Again, she has 2 great secondary weapons, being the C75 Auto and the SMG-12. Both are very good to use as secondary weapons with this gun. I found that this is one of the only shotguns that I like to use while attacking, since her secondaries are very reliable. Again, I think overall Dokkaebi has a great set of weapons, but like I said, I took a point off because she doesn't have a reliable full auto primary. The secondary weapons can definitely get the job done in close range, but they do have a quick damage drop off, so it makes it harder fighting at range, and they also have an insane amount of recoil. But now that we got her weapons out of the way, we're gonna now shift over and talk about her gadget more. And for the gadget, I have given Dokkaebi again a 9 out of 10. I think her gadget can be somewhat overrated, and it's kind of like a glorified version of Jackal, but it can be extremely effective at the same time. It is somewhat situational. You might not need it every attacking round, but again, it can be very effective for taking out roamers, especially in ranked play. There's always at least a couple roamers. And not only that, but very effective for last minute pushes when there's maybe one or two enemies alive, you don't quite know exactly where they are, and you're pushing the objective. If you call those phones, they might not have time to turn it off, and you'll be able to know exactly where they're at. She has two counters, however, one being if an enemy is close to the mute jammers, their phone will not go off, as well as echo directly, his phone will not ring, which can get you killed if you're being a little bit overconfident and you're just rushing in when you don't hear a phone. There might be an echo there, so you gotta be aware of that. As well, if the defenders do have a mute and they're holding the objective next to one, you might not be able to find them. But one of the best things about Dokubi is the ability to hack into cameras, especially if the enemy team is running a Valkyrie. It's almost a direct counter to her because you will have access to the Valkyrie cams as well as just the standard defender cameras. And this can be powerful not only just for knowing where the enemies are, but just finding out where the Valkyrie cams are if you're not running an IQ and being able to know where to destroy them from. There's been many rounds that I've lost as an attacking team because they have a Valkyrie on the defender side and we just can't find their cams and they destroy us with them. Information is key in Siege, and because Dokubi is able to gather a lot of information, I think that's what makes her have an amazing gadget. But like I said, Jackal can almost be more effective when finding one specific roamer if you're trying to use her for that purpose, but just kind of really throwing off the enemies and gathering intel, Dokubi is the best at that. But now that we have her gadget covered, I want to talk about her versatility. So for versatility, I have given her yet again a 9 out of 10. Really, my only kind of contention with Dokubi is the ability to kind of play medium to close range. Yes, she does have the secondaries, but sometimes they're not always the most reliable in terms of recoil and being able to take out the enemies, especially if you have somebody like an Ella that's just rushing at you while you have the MK14. You're not really going to be able to take her out with the M14 quicker than she can with a Scorpion. And then also the time it takes to switch weapons can also get you killed and put you in a bind. So that's really the only reason I would take a point off of Dokubi. She has the ability to play with smokes or claymores, which can be effective for bomb, whether you want a claymore, a runout, or use those smokes to help assist a plant. Overall, I think she is a great operator. So if we take a look at her overall score and the way the numbers play out, she gets a perfect 9 out of 10. I think she can be somewhat overrated and not necessarily the most needed operator, but she is amazing for gathering information. So as for why you should use her, that's probably your biggest thing, really countering the Valkyrie and trying to find out where the enemies are on those last second pushes. Even something as a 2v2 and you need to get into the objective when the time's running out, it can really put a panic on the defenders and allow you to win a round. And not only that, but it really kind of punishes the defending team for roaming, especially if they're out alone, not near their teammates, and you get a hold of their phone to hack the cameras. But with all of that said, that will pretty much wrap up this video. I really hope you guys did enjoy it. If you did, please make sure you hit that like button. I greatly appreciate the support. Also, feel free to comment down below. I would love to hear your guys' thoughts on Dokubi. Maybe let me know what your favorite weapon is to use with her and whether or not you think her gadget is useful. Also, feel free to maybe let me know what score you would give her. And lastly, if you are new to the channel, do not be afraid to hit that subscribe button. And as usual, you guys have a good one. Peace.